Why is it digging down?
No! Are you kidding me?
So you know how in the real world there are drones that can deliver packages to your house? Well, guess what? They now exist on the oldest Anarchy server in Minecraft, 2B2T. A group of players has created an advanced network of AI-controlled robots, where players can purchase items in bulk and have them automatically delivered to any location on the server. A delivery system this sophisticated has never been used on any other Minecraft server and has completely revolutionized 2B2T's economy. By using these automatically controlled Minecraft accounts, they are trying to turn an underground item selling operation into a legitimate business. So, where did these robots come from? And how does the delivery system even work in the first place? Are the robots ever in danger of being killed and losing their packages? Is a system like this even legal to operate? Well, today we're going to find out. We'll be uncovering this mysterious network of robots that has showed up on the server over the past few months, and we'll even receive one of these in-game deliveries to see if the system is legitimate. This is such a unique topic that I do have to put a disclaimer. As a Minecraft YouTuber, I cannot provide links to websites or services that might be in violation of Minecraft's EULA. For any website or service shown in today's video, I do not condone their usage. I'm only here to document them. Seek them out at your own risk. With that being said, let's get started. So where did these delivery bots come from? Well, a few months ago, a 2B2T player named Soiledcold was watching a documentary on the Silk Road, a website that used to operate on the dark web. It was used for the buying and selling of illegal things in the real world. After finishing it, he wondered if an underground operation like that could actually be used in Minecraft, a place where players could buy and sell items and have them delivered to their location on 2B2T. He got into contact with his friends Exoram and Redstoner and asked them if they'd be interested in setting up an in-game item selling operation similar to the Silk Road. Exoram was a developer and programmer, and Redstoner had knowledge of duplication exploits that he had already used to sell items in the past. Working together, their goal was to create the most sophisticated item selling operation in the server's history. While there have been groups in the past that have made decent money selling items, it's never been profitable enough to turn into a legitimate business. This is mainly because the players making deliveries could sometimes get killed in transit and have their items stolen. They could also make the deliveries, but then fall victim to chargebacks and other scams. That's when the trio realized using actual humans was risky business. Why not use robots running a combination of Baritone and Autobot so they wouldn't have to run this risk? The three got to work, and eventually, a website was finished where orders could be placed and paid for securely using crypto and other forms of payment. Since the Anarchy community is known for having a lot of hackers, they had to take the security of their service very seriously. Once the website was connected to their delivery bots, they could start doing business. The system is highly advanced. The most commonly purchased items, such as totems and god apples, are often put together in pre-organized stashes. Minecart chests are stacked on top of each other so that the stashes are harder for regular players to find. When an order is made, a delivery bot sets its respawn point at the stash and will pick up the order. They then take the items and begin heading to the destination. They use a combination of overworld and nether travel to get there as quickly as possible. Since the network is still somewhat new, and because getting disconnected is a common occurrence, only 3 out of 10 delivery bots are actively working on the server at once. To prevent them from being killed by hunters, they are programmed to never go within 2,000 blocks of nether spawn, which is usually the most dangerous part of the server. They are also instructed to automatically disconnect when being attacked to save their items. When they make it back to the overworld, the bots are capable of elytra flying, making them just like real-life drones. Once they arrive at the target destination, they will scan the area for the nearest chest so they can deposit the items safely. They usually choose ones in a dungeon or a mineshaft. Once the delivery is made, a screenshot is sent to the buyer of the items, showing that the transaction is complete. The bot will then harm itself and return to the item stash to prepare for the next delivery. Now, the system isn't perfect yet. Some deliveries do get lost due to bot malfunction or being ambushed by multiple PvPers and other random occurrences. These losses are taken into account during the production phase, which is why the stashes contain such a large amount of commonly requested items. If an order is lost, it can be replaced very quickly. To prevent stashes from being raided by random explorers, they have to be manually moved on a weekly basis. This can only be done by a human, not a robot. There may also be orders for unique items that are not in the common stashes. These require a human delivery due to their sensitive nature. Deliveries made within 100,000 blocks of spawn usually don't take very long, but deliveries outside this range can take a long time. Other than these drawbacks, the system is said to be completely automatic. But is this actually true, or is it a hoax? It's time for us to find out. I'll be logging into TubiTT on one of my alt accounts to receive a delivery in person. Exo has agreed to send me one for free so that I can film the entire process firsthand to see if these robot deliveries are legit. I never thought a drone would deliver items to me on an Anarchy server, but here we are. Welcome to the future. Let's do this. I've logged in on my alt K-pop Bob, which I've been using for my base hunting livestreams the past few weeks. It really doesn't have much gear on it, so I'll be receiving four different shulkers in this delivery. Enchanted golden apples, fireworks, totems of undying, and a random PvP kit as well. So I've just received word that the order has been sent to the bots, and one should arrive in less than 20 minutes. And there it is, right on schedule, the flying drone has arrived. That's pretty crazy. Oh yeah, here it comes. Now it looks like it's getting ready to land exactly where the coordinates were that I provided. Oh yeah, look at that, right on the spot. That's crazy. It's just been staring off in the four cardinal directions, so I'm assuming that it's searching for a chest right now to put the items in. The bot's just been standing on the beach for like the past 60 seconds, so I'm gonna make my own chest just to be safe. There we go. Oh, check it out, it's moving. Okay, so it didn't even need our chest. So let's follow it and see where it ends up. It must have found a mineshaft or something. It just sank to the bottom and now it's just chilling. Oh wait, oh, there we go. It's using a pickaxe to go through gravel, so yeah, it's definitely a robot. Very rarely do I get to follow automated Minecraft accounts, so this is still kind of weird to me. Oh, there we go. Oh, it's a mineshaft. Okay, so it must have found a chest in here somewhere, so let's see if we can find it. It must be through this way, but it seems to be snagged on a post right now. I'm sure it'll get through eventually, but maybe we can speed up the process by digging some of this gravel, so let's give it a shot. As soon as I finish digging, it's going through the post anyways. Oh, figures. But it looks like there's just a wall here now. I'm guessing it's gonna have to dig through solid stone just to get to this chest. Oh, there it is up there. It's a minecart chest. That's exactly what the bot is looking for, so I'm assuming that's where the delivery is going to be made. So, is the server lagging? Or did it stop digging? Oh, I hope my delivery bot does not get disconnected. That would be bad. There it goes. It's moving up towards the chest. All right, I think it started putting them in there, so let's just give it a little bit of time. All right, now let's check it out. Oh, yep, sure enough, it's starting to put the items in. There's the golden apples, the fireworks. Wow, so it's actually delivering them. That's crazy. That's what I was looking for. These totems are gonna come in handy for base hunting, but let's take a look at how far away we are from the original beach. Oh, wow, it's right there. They really did find the closest chest, and that didn't take long at all. I am very impressed. The bot must have received a different order because it's already moving again. So you know what? Let's follow it. Why is it digging down?
No! Are you kidding me?
Our delivery bot just pulled a Terminator. Oh my god, you gotta be kidding me. But it makes so much sense, so this way, no one can follow the bot back to the master stash. It's genius. After seeing that robot jump in lava though, you better be hitting that subscribe button because that was some top quality entertainment right there. So from what I can tell, the automatic delivery system does work. But remember, because this is a service run by 2B2T players and it likely breaks Minecraft's EULA, I cannot endorse this in any capacity. But it's crazy to me that a system this advanced can actually exist on the oldest Anarchy server in Minecraft. But that's it for today's video, everyone. Take it easy and stay alive out there.